Plum Island knows Mother Nature's mean side firsthand. Property destruction is unfortunately pretty commonplace there.
A few years ago, a group of residents had enough of it and dug into their own pockets for protection.
Even in the off season, Plum Island is a sight to behold.
We're just very, very lucky to live this close to the ocean.
But it takes more than luck to survive nor'easters here. In 2013, Chronicle visited Bob Connors and other residents after an epic storm tossed houses into the sea. Residents long wanted to armor the shoreline to protect their homes, but the state's Department of Environmental Protection said no.
When people arm their little section of the beach, the water still has to go somewhere. We have sea level rising. We have the shoreline receding. So people have to understand that's a process that, you know, we're not capable of stopping.
Plum Island is a narrow 11-mile long stretch of sand called a barrier island. Barrier islands protect the mainland coast, preserve ecosystems, and are constantly reshaped by currents, wind, and waves.
The reality is no one is going to retreat from the coastline. To retreat from the coastline is to surrender.
After the 2013 storms, residents banded together and fought successfully to put up rock walls.
I just give credit to Governor Patrick that we were in crisis, we were losing homes, and something had to be done. And the property owners were willing to do it with their own private funds.
TJ Conti and his wife Lisa Burke built a new house next to Connor's where a previous house was lost. Without the wall, would they have built on Plum Island?
No, absolutely not.
We're all in agreement that the rock wall is, you know, paramount to maintain and to keep for our survival out on the island.
These days, construction is back. Homeowners do their version of yard maintenance after big storms like the ones in March.
We had waves 22 foot high. This deck is 30 feet high above sea level. Not one single home was damaged on Plum Island. When you live on the coast, regardless of how much shoreline protection you have to be vigilant on monitoring the weather. And there is times when you should leave.
But not now, says Connors.
We've got more structures and residents that live within 500 feet of the coastline than most other states. We're here to stay.
Now, the rock walls may be working on Plum Island, but they are still very controversial.
Right, because, of course, the water can rush around them and go into low-lying areas. It affects some nesting areas as well. And this whole idea of a sort of a seawall for Boston, mm-hmm. very, very expensive. And, of course, you have to maintain the shipping lanes, and we spend a lot of money cleaning it up. You have to have a way to flush it out as well. So a little bit down the road, I think. And that is Chronicle for tonight. I'm Anthony Everett.
And I'm Shayna Seymour. Thanks for joining us. We will see you back here tomorrow night. Have a good one.